And joining us on Hot Copy this morning as we talk about the closure of some roads in Pasig City because of the subway project, we have with us this morning MMDA spokesperson, Attorney Mel Karunungan. Attorney Karunungan, good morning to you.
Good morning, Ma'am Karen, and to all those listening and watching.
All right. Now, let's not forget, first of all, this closure is until 2028. It's a partial closure of Meralco Avenue. You have motorists worried that for 6 years, the traffic might be unmanageable. Let's talk about the first night of the closure.
Yes, ma'am. Well, to give substantial input on the effects of the closure, ma'am, the representatives and officials of the MMDA, the Department of Transportation, and the LGUs will assess and reconvene after 2 to 3 weeks of this road closure. So we can definitely give substantial input after 2 to 3 weeks from yesterday.
Okay, but what measures are you taking to address the expected traffic in the area that can, of course, spread out to EDSA and other parts of Metro Manila?
Well, first, ma'am, the first measure that the LGUs, the MMDA, and the Department of Transportation took is to provide alternate routes for motorists, such as those that use vehicles, first, such as public utility jeepneys. So for these jeepneys, from Meralco Avenue, they may take the Captain Javier Street to Danny Flores Street to Shaw Boulevard and vice versa. For modernized jeepneys, ma'am, they may take from Meralco Avenue, they may enter Doña Julia Vargas Avenue to San Miguel Avenue, and then they may exit Shaw Boulevard and vice versa. For UV Express vehicles or UV Express units from Meralco Avenue, they may enter Doña Julia Vargas Avenue to San Miguel Avenue and exit Shaw Boulevard or vice versa. Or also they may take from Meralco Avenue, they may enter Capitol Commons and use the Ander Road to Camino Verde to Shaw Boulevard and then vice versa. And finally, ma'am, for private vehicles, all accessible routes are available to them.
Okay. Now, do you have a number already of just how many vehicles pass that portion of Meralco Avenue every day?
No, ma'am. Actually, it's still between, it's still to be accessed between 2 to 3 weeks. And we cannot say for sure the exact number of vehicles that will be affected by this road closure until then.
I see. Okay. So you have 2 to 3 weeks. Now, I know there's a commercial building and a gasoline station that will have to be demolished, correct?
The commercial building, ma'am, and I don't think the gasoline station is being demolished, but it's that the gasoline station, as far as we know, has been closed for this road closure.
Oh, so the gasoline station stays, but a commercial building will be demolished. Is that correct?
With that, ma'am, I'm not entirely sure about the demolishment.
Okay. All right. So now let's talk about the affected establishments. I asked you already about two. Do you have a list of other establishments that will be affected with the building of the underground subway?
Well, ma'am, in that area, the gasoline station has closed down. But as far as we know, the Estancia Mall will stay open. But of course, the clients of that mall will be rerouted to alternate routes as well. That's that has been instructed by the mall for its clientele.
Okay. Now, I know you are going to fence the area. Is it already confirmed that this closure is 6 years?
This closure is between 5 to 6 years. Of course, we can be hopeful that it will be less than 6 years, but this total closure, which is 24/7, is important so that this project can be completed within that time, ma'am.
Yeah. Are there other areas that you are predicting that might be affected with the project?
Yes, ma'am. Since this closure from Estancia to Shaw Boulevard will have to make the other cars move or use alternate routes, we are expecting that the spillover will happen in our major thoroughfares. And because of that, the MMDA has deployed additional traffic enforcers in EDSA Shaw Boulevard, at Ortigas Avenue, at C5, and also Julio Vargas near Lanuza, ma'am.
All right. Anything you'd like to announce, Attorney Karunungan, before we go?
I would just like to again remind the following vehicles, such as the public utility jeepneys, modernized jeepneys, the UV Express vehicles, and all other private vehicles, that they have alternate routes that they can take because there's a road closure from Estancia up to Shaw Boulevard. And this will happen starting yesterday up to 2027 or 2028.
All right.
That's all, Ma'am Karen.
On that note, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you so much, ma'am.